Manhattan, Kansas, also known as the Little Apple. Hi, everybody. I'm Brad Metzler. My partner is Kirk Kerbstreet. Aaron Andrews will be on the sidelines with us, and we'll hear from Reese Davis all day long from the studio. Welcome to another game of NCAA football. We're brought to you by Spark, who reminds you that what you can measure, you can improve. Today's game is between the Kansas Jayhawks and the Kansas State Wildcats. And the fans are on their feet awaiting the start of this game as the players line up for the kick. He's to the 10. Oh, man, did he take it again. Let's get the latest now from Reese Davis.
The Horned Frogs came into the game ranked 14th. A hard-fought and disappointing loss will cause them to slip some, but not too far, one would think, in the rankings. The upset is complete. And for Rogers, he got past the defense 3 times for touchdowns. Elsewhere, the Utes were ranked 22nd. Now they'll be lucky to hold on to a spot, any spot, in the poll. This was a tight one to the very end. USC wins it 17-13.
Thanks, Reese. No score on this one. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. They'll run the option. He takes it right side for a good game. So he picks up about 5 on the option to the halfback. Second and 5 coming up here. Ball on the 31-yard line. Now he tries to buy some time. He's to the 40. And he's tackled right around midfield.
Sometimes the defense does everything right, and they still lose. That time they had tight coverage, which left no options other than for the quarterback to take off.
First and 10, ball on the 50-yard line. Looks like an option here. He's taken down at the 47.
Good job by the defense to overpower the offensive line and drop the back for a loss.
From their own 47-yard line, it's second down. Option here. And he's taken down at about the 45. Third and 5 situation. Ball on the 45-yard line. They go with the option. Right down to the 32-yard line. It's first down. They'll run it. And down he goes at about the 17-yard line.
That'll move the chains over to Kansas State. First down.
The 17-yard line. First down. down about the 15-yard line. From the 15-yard line, second down. Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Tackle made right around the 8-yard line. 7 yards there.
They executed the screen play well here by getting the ball to the halfback. They pick up some yards.
This is the ninth play of this drive. Takes it up the middle for a nice one. So the ground game picks up another first down.
Well, this really works on a defensive psyche. You can see the guys on defense right now just trying to catch their whip. Once again, they had a chance to bring this drive to a halt, but were unable to do it. The offense really seems to be clicking right now. Surprise these guys to see the run coming at them, but they just couldn't stop it.
Kansas State with a 6-point lead. And he hits the PAT. A nice 10 play, 73-yard drive. That's good for a touchdown.
This defense is not only struggling, but they're giving up big plays. And that could really start to affect you and your confidence in trying to slow down an offense when you're giving up so many big plays, especially on the ground.
Warren fields it at the one. And he's tackled at the 26. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it.
Great shot by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 26. And he is drilled at the 36-yard line.
You know what? After a play like that, I wouldn't be the least bit surprised if they went to the air again.
It's third down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Everybody on their feet. Douglas off the right side. Tackle after a decent pickup. And a nice run by the tailback.
Not a lot of razzle-dazzle here, but it gets the job done and picks up the first down.
From their own 42-yard line, first down. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. The running back gets two on the carry.
That makes it second and eight.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 44-yard line. That's a live ball.
I really thought the defense had a chance to get their hands on it, but the ball went out of bounds first. That's got to be disappointing.
Third down, and they need to get it inside the 48. And this crowd is going crazy. Brown, back to pass. That's a great tackle at the 43-yard line.
That's the kind of rangy flanker every quarterback wants to be throwing to. He did well to make sure he had enough yardage to pick up the first down.
From the 43-yard line, it's first down. And Brooks got it on the quick throw. And he's level at the 35.
I think it was a great play call, and it was very well executed. Any coach would be happy with that kind of outcome on a first or second down play.
Here's the eighth play of the series. Frazier on the inside handoff gets out to around the 25.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executing. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's the third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25. Gives to the tailback. And they get nice yardage on that run. Frazier gains around 6 yards on the run.
Second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. End zone! Finds his receiver. Touchdown!
Excellent play here by the quarterback, making the proper reads and finding his playmaker for the score.
They got great concentration from everyone to connect on that flag pattern. Here comes the kicker to try to tie this game up. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So a 10-play, 74-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed technique.
We're even at 7 in this one. So if you're the offense here, what's your mindset right now?
Well, I think they're anxious to get back out on the field. Last time out, they drove right down the field, so they know they can move it.
And they make the stop around the 41-yard line.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
First and 10, ball on the 41-yard line. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line.
That makes it second and 8.
It's second down and 8. Ball on the 43. He scrambled. Tackle around the 49-yard line.
Gain of 6 yards. That'll bring up 32.
It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. Gets it to his wide receiver, and he's got another one. Here's an update from the studio and Reese Davis.
Let's have a look at some scores from around the country. Several surprises today. The Red Raiders deliver the perfect connection and a touchdown. The Red Raiders are out front, 7-6.
And for Kansas State, they met up with the Sooners last week. From the 32-yard line, first down. Holmes gets the ball. He's at the 20. He makes his way out to about the 9.
They've got a solid drive going here. I know it's not going to mean that much without putting some points up on the board.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
takes him a good 7 yards. From the 2-yard line, it's second down. This defense not wanting to give an inch here. Let's see if they can get the quarterback to attempt a pass this time.
Believe me, that one probably looked a million times better when they ran it in practice.
Here it is, folks. 3rd and goal from the 2. They go with the back, and he's in for the touchdown. Second touchdown of the day.
He's run the ball very well, and he's going to see a lot more carries before this one's over. It's really helped carry the offense so far today.
Kansas State is up by 6. And he tacks on the extra point. 8-play, 75-yard drive, and they add 7 points to the scoreboard. So our score, 14-7. Taylor is lined up to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 10. And what a play by the kicker to take him down. Well, they got the result you always want on the last drive. Let's see if it happens again.
So much of the passing game is about timing between the quarterback and his wide receiver. And right now with this offense, they are in sync and really the timing and execution is flawless. The defensive coordinator did a great job with the play call there. He put his defense in alignment and in a position to be able to make a play on the football. Everything worked perfectly. They just dropped the football. Boy, the offense caught a break there.
Back to pass. Right around the 38-yard line.
Gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and 4.
So it's 3rd down now, and they're going to need about 4. The crowd is deafening. They'll go ground. And he's taken down.
The defense off guard with a play-action pass there, but by going to the ground, they didn't have much of an opening.
Wow, what a first quarter we had. That was an offensive explosion. The Wildcats with a touchdown lead. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. Tackle at the 25. They'll set up shop at the 25-yard line. Kansas State is up a score. On the ground, right side. He's tackled at the 27-yard line. 1 yard, maybe 2 on the carry.
That'll make it 2nd and 7.
2nd and 7. Ball on the 27-yard line. Complete. He's got room. They'll bring it down at the 36. Down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 36. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. Let's go to the studio for this Reese Davis update.
Go
Guns up. Texas Tech doing battle in Lubbock. This is a game we've been watching closely all day long. The Red Raiders strike through the air, getting into the end zone for a touchdown. Texas Tech leads it 14-6.
People were predicting some upsets this week, but I'd be shocked if that score holds up. Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Down there on a 2-yard completion.
Nice play there to move the chains and keep the drive rolling.
From their own 47-yard line, first down. Takes the ball inside. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. Jones gets 6 yards on the carry. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Kansas State up 7 points. Back to pass. Fires it quickly. Covers hands and incomplete. Yards away here on third down. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. In a perfect world, he knocks this kick down inside the 10. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Throws it out, not loose.
The pass was right on target, so that took a perfectly timed hard hit to knock it free. It makes a strong defense to deny the completion.
From their own 20-yard line, second down. Douglas on the give. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. 3-yard gain by the running back.
They're lucky he was able to hang on to the football. He took a pretty good shot.
Well, player down, and his teammates obviously worried after that play. It's third and 7. Ball on their own 23. It's getting louder down in the field. Brown drops back. Airing it out long. Missed it. So the defense gets him to go 3 and out.
Good job here defensively forcing this incomplete pass.
Doesn't look like he's going to have much time to get rid of this punt. He just took a licking.
You're always looking for the home run return. The big highlight didn't happen there, but he still got him a couple yards.
Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. He drops back. Down he goes, right around the 42-yard line. They get a good 7 yards on that one.
Good decision here. Nice dump off. It's only 7 yards, but the offense will take that play every time.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Kansas State is up by a touchdown. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
Calling a loss of 1 yard on the play. That'll make it 35.
From the 43-yard line, it's third down. Gives it off. Tackle made around the 41-yard line. Let's get an update now. Here's Reese Davis. Reese.
guns up. Texas Tech doing battle in Lubbock. This one's been entertaining us all day long. The Sooners have a lethal pass-catch combination for a touchdown. All locked up, two touchdowns apiece.
And for Kansas State, they met up with the Sooners last week. It's first and 10. Ball on the 31. Takes the ball right. He's at the 20. Gains his way to the 16-yard line. It was the umpire that threw the flag, and generally, that's a holding penalty.
You gotta be careful to avoid these. Penalties are a great way to stall out a drive.
So first down once again, but a long ways to go after that penalty. Scrambling, and they got it.
Boy, this pass rush is sometimes scary. They're really getting after the quarterback now.
That'll make it second and long.
Defense looking for another sack in this second down and long situation. Kansas State is up 7. Holmes with the option. Tackle at the 49-yard line. A 1-yard gain by the halfback.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
Third and long here, and they hope to convert another one and keep this drive going.
To stop at about the 31.
That was a well-designed and executed pattern, but on third down and forever, it just wasn't enough.
It's fourth down. They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Kansas State can make this a two-possession game with this field goal. The kick is up. It's got the distance. And he nails the long field goal. And he's got to be happy about that kick.
Oh, no question. This kid is just a solid kicker.
17-7, Kansas State. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 10. They'll bring him down at the 23. They'll go to work at the 23-yard line. He's looking to pass. Rolls, he's right there, knocking away.
That makes it second and 10.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. That's a great tackle at the 30.
Lowe makes the tackle at the 30-yard line. That makes it third and
third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Crowd, a huge factor here.
Keeping an eye on this one all day. And for Oklahoma, they're struggling to take control of this game. Every punch has been counterpunched. A 21-21 tie.
Now you can never look ahead a week, but that would be a pretty big upset if that score holds. The punt upcoming, and they're going to come after this one. And down he goes to the 38-yard line.
Never want to see a kid down on the field after a play. Not sure what happened, but hopefully it's nothing serious.
3 points was the result of their last drive as the offense heads out for another. He gets rid of this one. Second down and 10 to go. Ball on their own 38. Holmes on the run. And he's tackled at about the 39-yard line.
That'll make it third and nine.
It's third down, 9 to go. Ball on their own 39. He drops back. Going deep. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Well, the offense catches a break here. That ball should have been intercepted there by the safety, so the quarterback gets the ball back here for this next down.
Wilcox awaits the snap. The offense will start at the 16-yard line. He's going to try and scramble. And he's taken down right around the 26-yard line. It's second down, and they're about the length of the football from the first down marker. So it's third down, and they're just inches away from picking up the first down. And this crowd trying to will their defense to make a stop here on third and short. They go with a toss. Nice run there. So he got enough for the first down there.
Yep, nice call to run the ball there on third down. I like it.
From their own 30-yard line, first down. He looks to throw on first down. Goes to the receiver, incomplete. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. Look at the throw. He's on a run. Runs with it, and he's got room. He's tackled right around the 40. And that was a nice pickup by the quarterback.
Brad, I think this guy's amazing. He has an uncanny ability to scramble, and it showed right there on that play.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 40. Frazier gets the call again. He fights forward to about the 43. But hold on, we got a penalty on the field. Let's check it out.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
So it's first down and an eternity. Down. Screen pass. He's got his halfback.
Frazier makes makes the catch.
He's taken down at the 45. They pick up good yardage that time on the pass play.
Here they kind of put pressure on the quarterback and challenged him to find the hole in the defense. And in this case, he did. Nice job.
Quick strike and he drops it. They'll line it up again on third down. And he's hit before he can go anywhere. And they'll go with a no huddle.
33-yard line. First down.
Drops back to pass. He heaves it deep. And it's picked off. It's the safety.
The defense here comes up with a huge interception. They've already got the lead. It looked like this offense is trying to get back in the game. That was a big turnover.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 40-yard line. Back to pass. Trailing around. They bring it down at the 50. The Wildcats will use their first time out of the half. From the 50, it's first down. First down and back to pass. He's scrambling. And down he goes at the 38. Kansas State's going to have to use their second time out of the half. First and 10. Ball on the 38. Gets it out quickly. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
They're calling an audible. Kansas State will take their final timeout. The field goal unit's out on the field, and they're going to try to get these guys 3 points before halftime. Kicks away.
Boy, he had plenty of distance there and pushed it through. Very impressive leg strength.
20-7, Kansas State. With only a few ticks left on the clock before halftime, I would expect they'll just squib kick this one. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He's to the 10. He's tackled at the 23. It's been a well-fought game as we head to the half. 20-7, Wildcats. Teams are lined up to start the second half. He gets a booming kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. Aaron Andrews has a report now from the sideline.
The average yards per pass was lackluster on both sides. And for Kansas State, they were able to force one mistake and will look for more to up their advantage. Back up to you, Brad.
They'll be looking to get in the end zone for only the second time. They'll set up shop at the 25-yard line. He sails it long. No, incomplete.
25-yard line. Second down. Brown drops back to pass. And is immediately tackled. That play was going nowhere.
Yeah, give a lot of credit to the defense here, recognizing pass and swarming to the receiver.
Third and seven coming up here. Ball on their own 28. This is where you get false starts. Great strike to the receiver. Tackle made right around the 36-yard line.
I like this wide receiver a lot. He knows where he needs to be on the field so the quarterback can get him the ball. He made a terrific play to keep this drive alive.
He drops back. He's in trouble. And his hands on it and dropped it.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
Second and 10. Ball on the 36. Looks to pass. Quick shot, and the defender tips it away. And they'll look to convert here on another third down. It's getting louder down in the field. Back to pass. Tackle at about the 33-yard line.
First down.
That was more than enough to pick up the first down. Next time, this defense will be playing on their heels.
It's first down and 10 now after picking up some great yardage through the air. Stop the 32-yard line. Defense looked like it jumped early.
They're giving away 3 yards and only making life easier for the guys on the other side of the ball.
First down and 5 to go. Ball on the 28.
They've been a little bit more aggressive here with their pass rush, and that time it paid off with an incompletion.
We've got a second and 5. Ball on the 28-yard line. And he's tackled at the 20.
Makes the reception. Simmons on the tackle at the 20-yard line. First down.
First and 10, ball on the 20-yard line. Fires incomplete. Tenth play of the drive. Sets them up with a first and goal.
There's very good chemistry between these two. They like to run through all their routes before the game. And I have to say, they look sharp before this one even started.
First and goal, and they need a touchdown here to get back in this game. We've got second and goal. Ball on the 14.
Third down and goal to go. Ball on the 14-yard line. They give to the tailback. That's a great tackle at the 16.
If these defenders continue to exploit the O-line like that, it's going to be a long day for this running back.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up, and he's got it. Yard line. Second down. Jones gets it here. And he's taken down at the 39.
Just a simple draw play there, but he picked up some big yards.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened. We've got a first and 10, ball on their own 39. He's on the run. He's tackled at the 42.
That's good for a gain of 3 yards. That'll make it second and 7.
It's second and 7, ball on the 42-yard line. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
Gain of 7 on the play. That'll bring up 3rd and inches.
It's 3rd down, and they're about the length of the football away from the first down marker. Try and scramble. Slides down to the ground. Second and 6 coming up here. Ball on the 30-yard line. Lambert again. He gets out to about the 14-yard line.
The defense doesn't seem to have an answer right now. They might need to change up some of their scheme.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. Holmes with the option. Sheds that one. Touchdown, what a catch.
Seems to make things happen no matter what kind of space he has to work with. All he needs is a little crease of daylight and forget about it.
So they had their chances to stop him, but in the end, he comes up with a big play.
Cincinnati hits the PAT. Nice 8-play, 74-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard.
Boy, how refreshing is this to watch an old-school offense just line up and simply pound the defense down the field? I mean, so many offenses spread defenses out. I just love to watch an offense just line up and simply line up around the formation, run the football, and put the defense on their heels.
So our score, 27-10. And down he goes at the 29. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Nice pitching catch for the first down.
You know, having a playmaker tight end makes those linebackers think twice before they make a move. That could be just enough time for the quarterback.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 46. Douglas gets the ball. Gets out to around the 45.
Gain of 9 yards. That brings up second and one.
It's second down now. They're just a few feet away from that first down marker. Can't find anyone open. They'll bring him down right around the 28-yard line.
That's a gain of 17 on the play. First down.
First and 10. Ball on the 28. He looks to throw on first down. Nearly picked off, but he couldn't hold it.
That makes it second and 10.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 28-yard line. At the 20. And down he goes around the 12-yard line.
Gain of 16 yards. That makes it first and 10.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 12. He steps up, and he tackles him hard at the 16-yard line.
Man, as an offensive lineman, this is the worst thing you want to see. Is your quarterback not only getting sacked, but getting hit like that. Those linemen better pick that quarterback up and start doing a better job of taking care of him.
There's an injured player on the field. Looking to dig themselves out of a little hole here after the sack. It's second and 14. Backup quarterback into the game now to call the signals. Draw play. The 10. He's in for the score, and they're back in it. He got the handoff and knew exactly what to do with it.
They like the fact that they have a halfback who can pick his way so well through defenses.
converts the extra point. Kansas is ready to kick it away. Sends it sailing downfield. He's to the 10. Oh, man, did he take it again. Pretty good looking touchdown drive the last time these guys were out there. Carrier gets to around the 42. From their own 42-yard line, first down. Holmes gets the call, decides to slide.
That'll make it second and seven.
Let's send it down to Aaron Andrews with an update. Aaron?
Thanks, guys. He came off the field holding his lower back, but even so, he's being told to rest the remainder of the game. Back to you.
Hopefully, he isn't out for too many games. Thanks for that update, Aaron.
Now he took the pitch there and was able to get the first down. It's a nice option play.
From the 43-yard line, first down. The end of three quarters to play. This one's a little tighter than the experts thought. 27-17, Kansas State. First and 10, ball on the 43-yard line. It's the tailback. And they make the stop at about the 31. Time for an update from the studio. Reese, what have you got?
The Badgers enter today's game ranked 8th in the country. The Badgers keep pounding away on the ground, and they find Pater. The Badgers are on top, 21-20.
10-point game here, Reese, 27-17. From the 31-yard line, it's first down. Inside give. He makes his way to about the 22.
That brings up second and 11.
Short yardage situation here. It's second down and one. Look at the throw. The man quick strike and he can't pull it in. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Him hard, the 7-yard line.
I like how the offense is using the pass to get him involved. He's explosive and just want to get the ball in his hands.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. The PAT. He's ready to kick this one off. He's to the 10. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. They'll start this drive at the 23-yard line. Trying to throw here. They line up on third down and 14. And this crowd is going crazy. Back to pass. Zips it left. He almost had it, but it's incomplete. Powell is back deep to return. Field position here. They'll start this drive inside their opponent's territory. He gets sacked on the play.
Personal foul.
So the offense will move a little bit closer with that penalty. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 33-yard line. Nice run there. Lambert gets about 4 yards on the play.
Makes it second and six.
It's second and six. Ball on the 29-yard line. The gun. Lambert gets 6 yards on the carry. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with five wideouts. He scrambled. And he dives and he's down.
You know that saying, get your thieves out because we're on a drive? This offense right now is on a drive. I mean, this is their third first down. They're doing just about anything they want, and they're really starting to wear the psyche of this defense down.
Looks like an option here. Tackle made around the 28-yard line.
Called a loss of 7 yards on the play. That'll make it second and long.
From the 28-yard line, it's second down. They hand it off again. He's tackled at the 16. So it's another third down upcoming here. Quickly to the tight end, incomplete. They'll call on the field goal unit here. It's up, and the field goal is good. Taylor gets set to kick this one away. He just drills this one. offense will take over at the 25-yard line. First down, looking to throw. He's to the 40. Right down, around the 44-yard line.
Getting the ball to your tight end and allowing him to make plays in the passing game can really open things up on the outside for your real speedsters.
From their own 44-yard line, first down. Give to the tailback. And he's taken down around the 47-yard line. Here's an update from the studio and restate.
Time to get you up to date from Lubbock.
And for Kansas State, they met up with the Sooners last week. From their own 47-yard line, second down. The 37-yard line. He hustles the troops to the line.
First down.
Fires to his tight end. Nothing to it.
Hardy was the intended receiver on the play. That makes it second and 10.
Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 37. Douglas gets the ball. And down he goes around the 39-yard line. Third down, and they need to get it to the 27. Just under three to go in regulation. Looks to pass. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry. He's taken down around the 26-yard line.
I like the call here by the defense to bring the heat with the outside linebacker. It was just a better call by the offense, and that's why it's a first down.
There's a player down. I'm not sure what happened.
Smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Here's the eighth play of the series. And their short yardage package. They go with the back, and he's in for the touchdown. Less than 2 minutes in the fourth quarter. And he adds the extra point. Set up shot at the 43-yard line. Up the middle. and he carries the ball for a nice game. Kansas will take a timeout. That's their first of the half. From the 37-yard line, second down. Holmes on the option. And they get nice yardage on that run. Jayhawks use their second timeout. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Gives it to the back. And he's tackled after popular yardage. They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down.
As a reliable tackler, as you can see from that last stop.
Second and 8 coming up here. Ball on the 17-yard line. On the run. Nice run, and he's brought down. Lambert gained 7 yards on that play. Fun and points than Kirk and I expected. Kansas State 37, Kansas 24. So, Kirk, how would you sum up the action of this one?
Kansas State came out here today and played with the heart and intensity that you love to see in a rivalry game. They should be very proud of their victory because wins don't come easy between these two teams.
His superb play merits the honor of player of the game. For Kansas State, they continue what should be a strong season by increasing their mark to 4-1. And for Kansas, it's been a pretty tough year so far as they fall to 2-3. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 13. With Kirk, Aaron, and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nessler saying goodbye. We'll see you next time.